If your computer's running slow or unreliably, you can use a restore point to roll back your PC to an earlier point in time without affecting your personal files. Windows creates restore points periodically in the background, usually during a Windows update or when you install a device driver, although you can also create them manually anytime. So if you ever have a problem and can't figure out why, you can roll back to an earlier restore point before the issues began. To take advantage of System Restore, you first need to turn it on if it isn't already. To do that, tap or click the search box and enter the word Restore. Then select Create a Restore Point from the search results. Under Protection Settings, select the drive that contains your Windows installation. This will be the one labeled System and is usually the C drive. If protection is turned off, click the Configure button below and select Turn on System Protection. Then, optionally, use the slider below to set the maximum amount of storage space you want to allocate to the restore points. We recommend keeping it to around 3-5% of your total space. As it fills up, Windows will automatically remove older restore points to make room for new ones, although you can also manually delete all restore points anytime. Once you've made your changes, click OK to apply them. Notice that protection on your system drive is now on, so Windows will now create restore points automatically in the background going forward. You can also create a restore point manually anytime by clicking the Create button below, then entering a description to help you identify it. Creating a manual restore point is useful if you're about to do any maintenance on your PC, as it allows you to undo those changes easily in case something goes wrong. Once it's completed, click Close to finish up. In future, if you experience any PC problems, you can head back to System Restore like before and undo any recent changes by rolling back to a previous restore point. Click the System Restore button above to get started, followed by Next at the initial screen, then choose a restore point to use from the list. In most cases, you'll want to use the most recent restore point, although you may need to switch to an older one depending on when the problems began. To help you decide, select one from the list and click Scan for Affected Programs to see which items will be affected. Any apps, drivers, or updates you installed after the restore point was created will be listed above and get deleted. Similarly, anything you removed since the restore point was made will be listed below and get restored, although they might not work correctly. Once you've selected the one you want to use, click Next, then review your selection and click Finish. Then click Yes at the final warning to confirm. This will start the restore process, which will take a while to complete, and will restart your PC automatically during the process. Once it's finished and you've signed back in as normal, you'll see a notification confirming the system restore completed successfully and that your personal files have not been affected. If you find that your issues still haven't been resolved, you can rerun System Restore, then either undo the last restore operation or choose a different restore point and try again. If you still have no luck, you can try resetting your PC instead, which we'll explore in the next video. Lastly, if your computer has a serious issue and Windows won't start up, you can also run System Restore from the Advanced Repair menu that's accessible when starting your PC. You'll have the option to load this menu automatically if Windows fails to start up normally twice in a row, although you can also get to it manually in a couple of ways. For example, you can start your PC from the Windows Setup disk if you have it, then choose Repair Your Computer from the Install screen to load the startup options. You can also start your PC from a USB recovery drive, which we've covered in a separate video. Once it's loaded, just choose your keyboard layout from the list, after which it'll load the same menu. Check out our video on advanced startup options for all the different ways you can access these options. Once you're there, select the Troubleshoot options from the main menu, then go to Advanced Options, followed by System Restore. This will restart your PC and prepare it for recovery. Once it's back up, choose an administrator account from the list and enter the password. If you need to change your keyboard layout, click the link below. Otherwise, click Continue to proceed. Then just follow the same steps as before to choose a restore point and start the recovery process, which will restart your PC again when it's done. So the next time your PC starts playing up, use System Restore to just roll back the clock and return to when everything was working smoothly.